just to give you kind of an idea of where I'm supposed to be. Over there. Yeah, if America was to be discovered by me, I'd probably still be looking for it. A little hazy, but nice shot of Tampa. I'm out exploring today, looking for places to fly. I'm currently in Ballast Point Park, came here by accident, and a goose almost pooped on me. Go figure. I'm out at the end of the pier. And still a little hazy, but Tampa looks beautiful. What you're looking at here is the whole South Tampa area. That's Bayshore. That's downtown Tampa. And then there's people fishing. But it's a nice pier. It's a long walk though. Pretty good place to put the quad up and get some good shots. Not bad wind here today too. It's just a little crowded. I'd have to wait till a Monday or Tuesday. Well, today is Monday. Happy Memorial Day. I'd have to wait until probably Tuesday or Wednesday to come here when nobody's here, and hopefully a little less haze on the city. That'd be a nice shot. You see, there's the pier where they say take a long walk off a short pier. I chose wisely because I took a long walk on a long pier. Yeah, because I'm smart like that. How can the wrong park be the right park? Well, it looks like this. Nice park. Lots of things for kids to do, but I can fly a quad through that. Little obstacle course or something like that. I imagine if I fly the quad with the GoPro in 4K, I'd get a pretty good shot of Tampa coming up out of these trees. It's like a nice little field here. Big enough to do have some fun, but not for it to get too far away. It looks like a lot of protection as far as trees go, because if your quad takes off, you want it to hit a tree and not anything else. I mean, because the bay is right there. This is a good obstacle course. I should have brought the little quad down with me. All right, well, let's go over to the next park. Because I, like I said, went the wrong way or picked the wrong name of a park. I was looking for Picnic Island and I got Ballast Point. Don't ask me how I got that confused. I don't. Now to our second destination. This is Gadsden Park. And looks like a pretty good park because look at the wide openness of it. A couple baseball fields over there that are wide open, but I think this grass field will do just fine. And I just so happened to have brought Bruce with me. So let's get him up in the air. All right, very nice light wind here, easily handled by Bruce, who is still my best flyer, although Bumblebee comes a close second. Let's go ahead and start him up and see what we got. So Bruce, not too bad. Damn it, the wind just doesn't pick up on me every single time. I had it up there and you can see, looking at it right now, it's in altitude hold, and it's holding its own pretty good. I had to give it a little boost on throttle. Then I switched it on into GPS, and you can see it kind of, I want to say wobbling or jerking or oscillating, but that's with the new tune settings, and I don't like that. I'm just becoming very frustrated with this flight controller. This is an APM 2.6 flight controller, and the problem with the APM 2.6 flight controller is it's experimental. You've heard me say it before, but it just... Too many cooks, and they're spoiling the broth as far as I'm concerned, so we're gonna have to go to something else. You also see Bruce is flying into the wind. I'm not turning him around right now because that wind is pushing him around quite a bit. He's got a big undersurface to catch the wind, so I'm just flying back and forth now. Again, I'm just not real super sure about the flight controllers. It's been a real journey with these things, and now they're at their end of life because APM 2.6 is going away. I have to really consider getting something like Super X and not messing with all the settings you have to mess with in order to fly one of these. It was never my intention to have to go through this much effort to fly a quad. It was over the top. So just to sum up, it was announced that the APM 2.6 will be end of life as of the next firmware release, which is 3.2. And that makes me very sad, but you're limited to what you can do. And again, I didn't really like working with these. It was way, way, way too hard for an amateur. And I fully recommend to you guys, if you're gonna get something, do not get a Pixhawk or an APM 2.6. So I'm gonna save, I've got two batteries. I don't know why I feel like I have to save battery life, got two. But I wanna go over to this Picnic Island because that really should be very, very scenic. These train tracks, train fields, and you're right on the shore. However, it should be a little bit windier. Wasn't that bad over at Ballast Point Park, but Gadsden Park, a little bit more wind, and the other one is more out to the bay, so I guess let's go find out. I got nothing else to do. It's Memorial Day, right? This is Picnic Island. Little bit smaller than I thought it would be. I guess the Commerce has most of it. Look at that big sand hill over there. So it looks like it's just a drop your boat in the water place. Nice beach over there. Well, it looks like I won't be doing too much flying here. Water seems pretty clear here. I don't know why I find that amazing. Why this is fenced off. It's a dog park. Hi, pup. Up. Look at all the happy dogs today. Can I open it? I don't want to have them run on you. There you go. I knew he was going to do that. Oh!
I got him. Don't worry about it. That one's Lou. Thank you.
No problem. Up. In you go. You can't go out. Look, dog getting a bath. I like that they have beaches like this for dogs. I mean, it's like a canine colony going on here. Look at that dog swimming out there. Oh, and a big puppy. Look at that puppy. I want to pet him. Come here, puppy. Hi. That puppy there. It's beautiful. Is that your puppy?
Yeah.
Can I pet him?
Sure.
What a nice dog. Look at this puppy. Hi, how are you? Oh, you guys are all wet. Oh, thank you for that, Mr. Frenchie. I got a bit of a shower. So, not bad at all. I like this. I wonder if I can bring my cats down here and I get some exercise. Because it looks like a lot of dogs want some exercise, chasing cats. Look how happy these doggies are. Look at doggies. He got his prize. Oh, this is a pretty damn long dog park. I came in over there, and it goes all the way up to the fence here. And there's another valley. Apparently there's a lot more to the park here than I thought. Winds aren't too bad here, but I'll wait till day when nobody's here to put the quad up. So back through the dog park, maybe we'll get attacked by a dog again. Okay, here comes a cute puppy again. He's so fluffy and beautiful. We're gonna get him again. Excuse me, what kind of dog is your puppy?
Mine?
Yeah.
Shepherd.
Really?
Yeah.
I thought he had a little bit of wolf in him. He is just so beautiful.
Thank you.
What's his name?
Reed.
Hey, Reed, come here.
Reed.
Come here. Just to take a walk on the other side of the beach. There's the dog park I was at down there. That's St. Pete again. Oh wait, no, it's Clearwater, that's St. Pete. Just so you know, I'm a little bit closer, not much. But just wanted to get the other angle. Just gonna get a view from the hill. Looking down, there's the dog park. If I had brought Bumblebee with me, I would have been more tempted to put the camera up because it shoots the GoPro. Bruce only has that little FPV camera, which is hit or miss on shooting, so. Well, I think that does it for me hunting for quad spots around the area. I think Gadsden Park is probably gonna be the best place. I may come out here again just for scenery. So, from a dog park somewhere in South Tampa, Florida. Woof! I think those are horses. Mighty Thor from Tampa, Florida in a big old dog park. See ya!